You're ready now to tackle project 5, which is the numerical solution of the two-body problem. In this video, I want to show you what the governing equations are, and then show you how you can actually reduce the two-body problem to a one-body problem, which will be easier to solve numerically. And then in the next video, I will set up how you go ahead and solve the one-body problem. So here we have two masses, M1 and M2. We've defined a coordinate system. So M1 is at position R1, and M2 is at position R2. If we use Newton's second law, F equals ma on this problem, we would get M1 times the acceleration of mass 1, which is R1 double dot. And that's equal to some force on M1 due to the gravity of M2. The equation for M2 would be M2 R2 double dot. And that's equal to the equal and opposite force on M2 due to gravity on M1. So this is minus F. And the forces here are both vectors. OK, so this is Newton's second law. And then the force comes from Newton's law of universal gravitation. So the force is proportional to the product of the two masses. The proportionality constant is the gravitational constant. So capital G times M1, M2. And inversely proportional to the distance between the two masses. It also lies on the, it's a vector force along the direction connecting the two masses. So the vector we can write as R1 minus R2, as shown on this diagram. And it's an inverse square law, so it's inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two masses. Because we have an R1 minus R2 in the numerator, we would have the distance here, R1 minus R2 absolute value, and then cubed, or modulus cubed, in the denominator. So this represents an inverse square law. And we have to get the sign right. So this is F, the force on R1, the force on M1. The force on M1 is in the opposite direction of R1 minus R2, pointing from M1 to M2. So this gets a minus sign. Then the force on M2 is minus F, is pointing towards M1. OK? Those are the governing equations, completely general governing equations. But it turns out, and it's well known, that you can reduce the two-body problem to a one-body problem if you use what's called the center of mass coordinate system. Okay? So let me define here then the center of mass coordinate system and show you what the resulting one-body problem is. So the center of mass coordinate system changes from the R1, R2 vector to the R vector, which is the relative distance vector, R1 minus R2, and the capital R vector, which is the center of mass coordinate, which is a weighted average of R1 and R2. So it's M1 times R1 plus M2 times R2 divided by M1 plus M2. So capital R is a vector which points somewhere in between M1 and M2. And if, say, M1 is heavier than M2, then it points somewhere in between that's closer to M1 than to M2. Okay? So this is our new coordinates. Then what we can do is we can eliminate R1 and R2 in this expression in favor of R and little r and capital R, and write the differential equation for little r and capital R. what we I do that in my notes, I won't do that here. What we find is capital R double dot, the acceleration of the center of mass coordinate system is always equal to zero. That will turn out to be a great simplification. And we also find that this reduced mass mu, which I'll define, times R double dot is equal to F. F is already in terms of R, because R is just R1 minus R2. This mu is called the reduced mass. And is equal to M1 times M2 over M1 plus M2, okay, which is always less than M1 and M2. So that's why it's called a reduced mass. Okay, so these are our equations. The first equation will just will be very simple to solve. The second equation we'll see, we'll write that simply as R double dot is equal to minus K times R over R cubed, okay? And this K constant will be the coming from the masses. It doesn't really matter, because we'll use that in the non-dimensionalization of the equations, okay? So that will be the equation that we'll solve numerically. I'll show you how to solve that equation numerically in the next video. Once you have the solution for R, then we can recover R1. So R1 is just M2 over M1 plus M2 times R. We can solve for R1. And R2 is equal to minus M1 over M1 plus M2 times R. You see here that R1 minus R2 is equal to R, okay? So let me summarize. I'm setting up the governing equations for the two-body problem. That's F equals ma applied to both masses using as the force the universal law of gravitation. This is a two-body problem because we're considering the acceleration of both masses at the same time. We can reduce that to a one-body problem by defining the relative coordinate vector, R, being R1 minus R2. You see how that shows up in the force law. And by defining the center of mass coordinate vector, capital R, as M1 R1 plus M2 over R2 times the sum of the masses. When we change the differential equations to equations in little r and capital R, we get the acceleration of capital R equals zero, and we get the equation for the relative coordinate with a reduced mass in front. Okay, so the reduced mass is M1 M2 over M1 plus M2. That won't really matter, because we'll see that this equation, the second equation here, is just R double dot equals minus KR over R cubed. K is a constant that depends on the masses, but in fact, we can non-dimensionalize the equations so that K will essentially become one, okay? In the next video, I'll show you how to solve for R. Once we solve for R, then we can solve for R1 and R2. Once we know R1 and R2, then we can plot the motion of the masses under the gravitational force. That's what your final result for the fifth project will be a graphics of the masses moving under mutual attraction due to gravity. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.